Dynamic NAT simply means that the router will have several IP addresses available for translation, as opposed to just one address in the case of static NAT. The configuration is very simple, and at MikroTik we don't even use the term dynamic NAT, as it is just another variation of source NAT. But let's have a closer look. This method could be used by people who have several public IP addresses from their ISP and a bunch of LAN devices that could share those IPs. In today's world, it is not a very likely scenario. One public IP address with masquerade set up is more than enough for most organizations. Even if you have servers that need to be reachable from the internet, you can simply expose a couple of ports and do port forwarding. You get the point. Dynamic NAT is used when there is a good reason to do so. But let's have a look at the configuration. I have created this little virtual setup. On the right side, I have two devices in a LAN, and they are connected to a gateway through which they could reach a third device. I put it in a second local area network instead of pretending that I own public IPs, because the configuration is just the same. So we have three addresses that we can translate to. Here is how we can set that up. I will open up the terminal to my gateway and I will go to the NAT section. There I will enter add chain source NAT, action source NAT. Source address is just going to be my local area network. The out interface is the one connected to the third router. And then finally, I have to add the two addresses, which is simply a range from the first to the last of my available addresses. Now, if I start up the sniffer on R3 and ping it from R1, you can see that the traffic is coming from 10.11 address. And if I now ping from R2, the traffic appears to be coming from the 10.12 address. It is working. This is all good if you have several consecutive addresses to translate to. However, in the case where you have public IPs that do not come one after another, then you will need to create several separate NAT rules, one for each address. The only complication with that is NAT rules work just like firewall rules, where they are applied in order. So you have to select for when the rules are applied. When you add a rule, press tab, and you will see many different attributes that you can apply. You can use source address, a routing mark, random, maybe you want 50-50 chance for your rule. There are many options, even the per connection classifier. Perhaps you can come up with a simplified PCC load balancing setup. It is all up to you to play around and see what happens. But I'll see you next time.